Hey guys, I'm Captain Duck, and this is a classic. This is in emulator Stella. This is Dig Dug. This is a very old game. It's from 1983, as you can tell. It's one of the first games I remember playing. It's been a long time since I played this. Now I've played this on emulator a couple of times, but since I really played this on a console, it must have been over 25 years now. But this is a classic game. This is one of the games that really got me into gaming as well. And that's what I want to show in this series as well. I'm starting a series of classic video games. Games I love, that I remember from my youth. And well, this is sure one of them. And well, it's running in a track mode, by the way. I'm not playing at the moment. Can see a bit of the gameplay here. You move around. You dig your tunnels. This is like a very old predecessor to Minecraft and Dwarf Fortress and digging games in general. Probably one of the first which has this digging sort of theme. And well, let's play a bit. It's a game I know very well. And let's try. If I press space, we should be able to start. And one of the most awesome things about this game is the music. Weird thing though, if you don't move, it has this little alarm sound. If you do move, it makes this awesome music. Also, you kill enemies by bicycle pump. It's a perfect sort of Dutch pastime. You're blowing up enemies with a bicycle pump. You have enemies, you have a bicycle pump, you blow them up. That's what we do. And well, this is actually a Japanese idea anyway. It's an old Namco game. It's one of the first Namco games, as far as I know. Oh, and here comes a dragon, and here comes a guy from below. Also, so yeah, you have two types of enemies. You have the dragons, you have the Vygars, you have the Pukas, which are the orb things. And if you kill all the enemies except one, the last enemies will try and flee to the top left of the screen, and well, we can let it happen. There's nothing bad happens if the enemy actually flees. You can just let him leave. But well, for more points, and arcade games are all about points, of course, you have to kill all the enemies. And let's not let you leave, guy. But yeah, what else was I talking about? Well, music. It's a very weird idea to have to move for the music, not to muse for the music. It's not something. But yeah, it's a pretty classic idea, and you don't see it much. Even nowadays, there's maybe, I think I've played an indie game which tried to do a sort of similar thing once, but it's something you really only see in this old classic game. And most arcade games don't have that either. It's just something Dig Dug did. Ah, words. Words are hard. But this game, it's not so hard though. The Atari 2600 version at least. I remember playing this game for hours and hours upon end, because yeah, this is one of the few Atari 2600 games where you don't die like after the third screen. If you're bit decent, of course. You can actually play this for hours, and yeah, you can also kill fires with rocks, or dragons with rocks. Just still call them dragons, because hey, they breathe fire, so because of that they are dragons. Yeah, what else can I tell you? Well, part of this challenge is the game is when the enemies come with multiple in one box. Like they just did there, and yeah, you gotta be careful if there's like two dragons coming towards you, because you'll pump up one dragon, and then the other dragon will try and burn you, because they can spit fire, and should not let that happen. But if you're fast, you normally can kill both of them at the same time, but yeah, gotta spam the button. Also gotta be careful here. Ah, fuck! He actually got me. Why? Because we could do a little roguelike run of the game with one life, but no. It's my excuse is that it's been very long time since I've played this game and played this for real for more than like 10 minutes. Need some practice with this, of course. That's arcade games, you just do it for the points and see how far you can last, because yeah, this is an infinite game, by the way. There's no ending. It's the game loops and loops and loops, and you get back to the same color schemes, but then there's more enemies and it gets harder. That's game design of the olden days, of the arcade days. There's no idea of stories yet back in those days and endings and stuff like that. Just infinite gameplay made to eat all your quarters. And hey, there's another color change. Nice. And yeah, seeing a color change is about all you have to you can get in this game. And yeah, here's a pro tip. If you leave a little wall like this, you can shoot through it and not get hurt in the meantime. Also, the dragons can only fire their stuff vertically. Also, you can drop rocks on them. Whop! And dropping rocks give you more power. Oh, he's going to flee. I can't make it. The bastard. Oh yeah, and story-wise also is something I should tell you. There was sort of a story, at least in my in a Game Boy version book that I played, I think there was a story. You are the Dig Dug, or the Dig Dug guy, or Taizo Hori, maybe? That's also what he's called in the Mr. Driller series, because Mr. Driller series is related to this. Well, you have a garden, and this is your garden, and you notice all sort of monsters under your garden, so what do? You go digging in your garden with a bicycle pump and blow up all those monsters. Perfectly logical things to do, and yeah, that's the story. It's old game logic. It's not like Mario makes more sense, but saving princesses and eating mushrooms, it's even weirder, maybe. At least the mushrooms part. But yeah, I could probably go on with this for quite a while. Next time I die, I'll end this part of the video, and then I'll show you the original arcade version, which I never played in real life, but well, it looks a lot better like this, and that's the original version which most of you, most people remember. And that's, yeah, most ports look like that, but well, the Atari 2600 couldn't handle that. And oh hey, we're back to normal vision. Let's get this guy. Oh, and you don't have to kill him if you don't press hard enough. Oh, I got two. Come on. Ah, he got me diagonally. Well, this has been long enough for this part anyway. This could go on for hours and hours and hours. Well, until you die, but yeah, I won't film all that. I'm running out of words to say about this anyway. Let's pause and I'll move to the original arcade version of the game, which looks a little bit better. See you guys in a second. Okay, here we are in MAME and loading the original arcade ROM, which was made in 1982, the year I was born. And yeah, I'm 30 years old. And it had some amazing stats. Look at the CPU. It's a 3x3 MHz CPU. This is nothing. This is absolutely nothing nowadays. Even a phone has there's gigahertz phones. There's quad-core gigahertz phones nowadays. Yeah, that's like 4000 MHz. This is a 3 MHz game. But let's start. Also, resolution 288x224, which is nothing, and the screen is very damn small on my monitor, but I'll play this, and I hope this will work in the video as well, because of the multiple resolutions, but I'll figure something out for that. There's probably some black bars on the side now. But let's play. Let's press enter and start the game. And since it's an arcade ROM, it starts with a little self-test like this, which looks weird, but it should be over in a second. Also, let's move the mouse out of the screen and show you the little attract mode, the mode you get when you start the game and don't press any buttons yet. This is to attract players, that's what it was called. And look at this little cave in effect over here. That doesn't actually happen in game, but well, it's a nice idea. It's a cave in, sort of dwarf fortress-ish. Well, not really, but well, dwarf fortresses also have caves in, whatever. Words are a thing. But let's start the game. If I enter some coins. Which is 5 with MAME, then start with 1, then we start the game. And as you can see, the graphics in this version are a little bit better. Although very tiny, but yeah, that's how things were back then. And oh, wrong button. The 0 is my fire button this time, not space. 0 on the numpad, by the way. And there goes all the enemies, and there goes the last one trying to flee. But we'll head him off here. And gameplay-wise, the Atari 2600 version, which I played earlier, is about the same. You just move around, you pump up those enemies with your bicycle pump. That's what you do. And that's it, really. And, well, it just looks a whole lot better. It's just like the Atari 2600 had no graphical powers at all. It's like a 1 megahertz per machine or lower even. And, well, let's be careful here. Oop. There we go. That's how you finish levels. But yeah, this is the original looks of the game, or the soundtracks as well. Also the same mechanic where if you walk, you get music, if you don't walk, you get a sort of alarm sound. It's, classic. And, yeah, this is an awesome game. It's, what can I say? Never really played this version, as I said, though, but, I would say there weren't any arcades when I grew up, but there were, but I just never went to them. The idea of spending money for video games was really weird because I had consoles, and yeah, Atari 2600 and the Game Boy and the Super Nintendo later. Why would you ever go to an arcade? But that's Dutch thriftiness, I guess. But that's okay. Saved me money when I was smaller. And thankfully we have emulators nowadays, which we can play these sort of games in. Although, if you want to get this game legally, it is possible. There's some legal versions which you can get even nowadays, even right now in 2012. There's a couple of versions. There's a Wii version you can buy, I think. Pretty sure there's a Wii version. There's also should be an Xbox 360 version. There's an iOS version. Dig Dug Remix, I think, is that called. I read that on the wiki at least. Don't have an iPhone, so no idea. There's probably a clone in the Android store somewhere as well. It's one of those old classic games which is on all systems, so yeah. Ooh, that was almost very bad. But yeah, this game has been on so many systems. It's like Doom, basically. Well, it's not on all systems like Doom is. Doom has been ported to basically every fucking system. Although, this game is much older than Doom, though. Maybe some more system, but there's other games like Space Invaders. That's literally been ported to every fucking system ever. Oh, fuck. Yeah, I got myself into a pickle there. But yeah, here on Mobi Games, which I have off-screen, which you can't see, but there's a little list of systems which this game came out on, and it's on a lot. It was on the Atari 2600, 5200, 7800, the Apple II, like old Apple II classic, Atari 8-bit Casio, which is, I think, just a calculator, a PVU-1000, no idea what that actually is, Commodore 64, you probably know that, Game Boy, Game Boy Advance, Intellivision, MSX, CNES, Palm OS, PC, PC 88 even, PC Booter, no idea what that is. Oh god. But it's taking too much time. A TI-99, a VIC-20, Wii, Windows Mobile. Oh, Windows Mobile, of course, as well. And Xbox 360. No idea if it's on the Windows 7 Mobile, but I think it is on the Windows 6 and 5 Mobile. But that's a different beast than the Windows 7 Mobile and Windows 8 Mobile for nowadays. Also, I died. Game over. But, go for the world record now. This screen has at least has a game over screen, but hey, I have a score, I have the high score. You could enter my name here. And yeah, that weren't really high scores put in the base game, but that's arcade versions, those should be held by people. And well, let's enter my name. Let's switch left and right. Let's enter Duck. And do D-U-K because it's only three letters, of course. And didn't I throw in, like, a whole lot of coins? Oh well, that's... Games like this, you can't continue. You can continue, but now you just need to press again and you can... To continue game, yeah. Press and hold pump button? What the hell is a pump button? Press one again? Yeah. But you just start from the one again. You can control any all the coins you get. You want, but you have to lose three lives, and from then you can start again from the start. But that's enough of this. Let's kick the death and finish this video. I hope you enjoyed the start of this the classic series. I'll do some more classic videos, games on classic systems, which games I've played when I grew up, and games I like and remember fondly. And this is one of them. This is, like I said, one of the first gaming memories I have. This is probably one of the first games I ever played. Another one is Frogger, but I think I'll move on to the Game Boy next, because I remember that better than these Atari 2600 games. And, I'll see. I'll make a lot of videos like this, and I hope you guys will enjoy. And, as I said, if you want to get this game legally, it's possible. It's on iOS, it's Windows Mobile, it's probably on Android, no idea. It's on the Wii, it's on WiiWare, and there's probably an Xbox 360 version as well. And there's so many releases of this game. If you look for it, you'll find it. But, this has been enough of this game, and I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you guys later.